Good morning, and welcome to St. Joseph Church. Have the following announcements. Happy Father's Day to all fathers gathered here, and also we'll have a blessing for you and a little gift. We have little pocket crosses that you can take along. And I told Father Christian that you might have someone that maybe is at home or a father or know someone that you can give them a pocket cross as well. So I think there's plenty. If not, I'll pull out my finger rosaries. Yeah, so anyway, for the other masses. So happy Father's Day to you. Today, the KSC has a breakfast, and that's at their clubhouse until 11 o'clock. Tomorrow evening, we'll have a men's club meeting at room 306. And that begins at 6:30. So for all men in the parish, if you'd like to come to that meeting, we have many things going on. If you'd like to help and be involved with our men's club, and so that will be tomorrow evening in room 306 in the parish center. Bosco Youth Program, they meet on Wednesday evening from 8:30 to 9:30, and that's at the Bosco House. This week, St. Joseph and Holy Family Parishes will have a vacation Bible school here, and they'll be here all week, so in the morning. For all those participating, please keep them in your prayers for all the families, the volunteers, the guests, and that they enjoy an engaging weekend of faith here at Vacation Bible School this week. Next Sunday at the 9 a.m. Mass, Father Darnus will have that Mass, and we'll have a little reception after that Mass, and we'll do that in the plaza. And we'll have a little special treat there if you'd like to come and wish him well for his next journey, his ministry at St. Matthew's in Mount Vernon. And he'll be leaving on June 26th, I believe. On that Wednesday, he'll be leaving us. And then also on that next Sunday, we'll have a potluck meal in the evening at 4 o'clock. So if you'd like to be a part of that, there's sign-up sheets for that. If you come to bring a covered dish, we'll take care of the meat and the drinks and stuff for that as well. So that'll be taken care of. So there's sign-up sheets on both counters if you'd like to be a part of that. Confirmation, preparation, classes for adults. If you have not received the sacrament of confirmation and you would like to, please contact the office. One of the things of being a confirmation, sometimes you're being asked to be a sponsor at baptism for being a godparent, or maybe a sponsor at confirmation, and you need the sacrament of initiations, all three of them, to be that sponsor. So if you're missing the sacrament of confirmation, contact the office, and it looks like I think June 26 will be the first class. So we'll have a couple classes with that. We'll see how it goes with that. Also, the parish, the youth, will be having a appreciation trip at Holiday World, and this is for choir members, mass servers, lectors, ushers, and Eucharistic ministers. The trip will be Wednesday, July 10th. All youth involved will receive a letter in the mail this week. There will be an extra letters available at the parish center if you'd like to go. So please return all forms by July 1st. So just to let you know of that. So if you'd like to go to that. There's a lot going on, so please read the bulletin. And so now let us stand and welcome one another.
Sing to the Mountains, number 542.
Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea.
to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice. Let all the earth rejoice.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, we come together on the Lord's Day to offer our God thanks and praise and to seek His grace. Today, in many places in the world, including our own country, is Father's Day. And so today is a special day to give thanks for the gift of the fathers and father figures that we have in our life and to pray for them. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We pray.
Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas, and since without you, mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Any of our children who are in pre-K through first grade to come forward, who, if you'd like to participate in Children's Liturgy of the Word, then come forward and join, and then we'll give you a blessing. Okay, well, I saw this guy's hand go up first. Okay, so, may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches, tear off a tender shoot, and plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel I will plant it. I shall put forth branches and bear fruit, and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of its boughs. And all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of the Lord.
To give thanks to the Lord, to sing your praise, your name most high, to proclaim your kindness at dawn and your faithfulness throughout the night. Lord, it is good to give thanks to The just one shall flourish like the palm tree, like a cedar of Lebanon shall he grow. They that are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. They shall bear fruit even in old age, vigorous and sturdy shall they be, declaring how just is the Lord, my rock in whom there is no wrong. Lord, it is good to give thanks to
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
the seed is the word of God. Christ is the sower. All who come to him will
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land and would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow, he knows not how. Of its own accord, the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the grain and the ear. And when the grain is ripe, he wields the sickle at once, for the harvest has come." He said, "To what shall we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed that when it is sown in the ground is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants and puts forth large branches so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade." With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them, but to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord. Don't go into farming. I can hear my mother now telling my two older brothers and myself, "Don't go into farming." Farming is the family business. My grandfather Bill started farming in 1949, 18 years old, bought some land, and started farming corn and soybeans. My uncle farmed, my dad farmed, two generations of farmers in the Hart family, and my mother was committed to making sure there would not be a third. She told my brothers and myself, "Don't go into farming. It doesn't always rain. Sometimes it rains too much, but more likely you won't get enough rain. Prices are sometimes low. If you have a business, you can sell your product for however much you want. But in farming, someone else tells you how much your bushels of corn and beans are worth. And if it's a low number, and if it didn't rain, you won't make enough money. And worse yet, whether you make a profit or not, you still have to pay property taxes on all your acreage. Don't go into farming. Get another job." So needless to say, my brothers became farmers. Mom talked them into it. They say that there are no atheists in foxholes, and I don't know whether that's true or not, but I would say that the same thing is true of farming. It takes faith to believe that those little seeds you put in the ground will become something big enough to support a family with, to put a roof over your head. It takes faith to believe that the rain will come, that the prices will be high enough, that this fruit will be worth something, that if we do have a bad year or two, that somehow we're going to make it. God will get us through and we'll be okay. Jesus is the ultimate farmer. He plants into our hearts the word of God, the word that we have just heard in our readings today, and that word is watered and strengthened during the liturgy of the Eucharist, when we receive his grace poured out into us by his body and blood from the cross. His grace rains down on us when we eat his flesh and drink his blood in remembrance of the sacrifice he gave for us on the cross. Christ loves us. Christ plants that little seed in our heart, that seed to love God, that seed to love our neighbor, and he waters it with his grace, but he doesn't do all the work. He can if he wants to. He's God, but he doesn't want to do all the work alone. Christ wants us to be his friends. Christ wants to work with us, to have a relationship with us. He asks us to help him cultivate that seed. He asks us to help that small seed of faith planted in our heart to grow until it is the largest of plants, until it is like a tall cedar on a high and lofty mountain with its mighty boughs stretched out. We help the seed grow when we love God and love our neighbor. We might not know how to do this, but that's okay. Just start small. Commit to one small thing. Give one small thing to God and let him make it grow. Come to Sunday Mass. I might be preaching to the choir. You're already here. But come to Sunday Mass whether you feel like it or not. Come if you're tired, if you're busy. Excuses are like weeds. You'll never get rid of all of them, so come anyway. Volunteer for one thing. Let's all do at least one good deed for somebody other than ourselves. Visit that one elderly person you know who doesn't leave the house too much anymore. Call and check in with that one person you know. Maybe you don't like them that much, but they could sure use a friend for at least 15 minutes. Let's all do one extra thing for our parish that we're not already doing. Sunday Mass is great, but God is inviting, not demanding, inviting us to a little more, to plant a little bit more in our community. Could that be by joining the men's club, volunteering at St. Vincent de Paul, coming to coffee and conversation after the Tuesday or Thursday morning masses, or after the Sunday morning masses on the second Sunday of the month, to get to know our brothers and sisters in Christ a little bit better? If any of us are in high school and not going to our Bosco youth group on Wednesday nights at 8:30, could Christ be inviting you to come and see? To come and see that you're not too young to grow in the faith with your friends. For those of us who are adults and are not yet confirmed, is it possible that God is asking us to come and take that time of prayer and receive the grace of that sacrament to grow closer to him? When we read our parish bulletin, not during the homily, do we see a particular ministry or event that God is calling us to? Is God inviting us to pray more to him daily, even if just a minute, to read his scripture daily, even if it's just a verse, saying, I know that you might not have much time, but if you gave just a little more time to this, I promise I will make your faith grow until you are like a majestic cedar, with birds of every kind resting in the shade of your boughs, until you are like a tree that once withering now blossoms in splendor. What we are giving to God now, let's commit to giving him just a little bit more. We can think to ourselves, I sin too much, I don't have enough faith, I have doubts, I'm not sure if the church really wants me. I'm not sure if Jesus really wants me because I'm not good enough for that. I can't live up to that. There is not enough in me to live up to that calling that God has given me. And Jesus says, give it to me. What little you have, give it to me. Oh, you're right. It's not much. It's the size of a mustard seed, but it's enough. Go into farming. We may not know what the harvest is going to look like. We may not know what the yield will be, but that's okay. To paraphrase St. Paul, we plant by faith, not by sight.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and a life for the world to come. Now let us bring our petitions before the Lord.
For the church, that it may manifest patience and hope throughout the world for the fullness of God's peace and justice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who continue to live in exile from family or country, and for all who have lost hope in the future, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whose faith needs nurturing, and for those who support them through prayer, teaching, encouragement, and understanding, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For gardeners, farmers, teachers, counselors, artists, and all whose work involves trusting in future outcomes, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For deacons Caleb, Philip, and Tyler, as they prepare for their priesthood ordination, may the seed of faith continue to grow in their lives as they begin their ministry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all fathers and stepfathers, grandfathers and godfathers, for all men who serve and nurture young people, for their strength and tenderness, courage and wisdom, generosity and faithfulness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill or in need of our prayers, especially those in the hospital, nursing home, homebound, and those near death, may the Lord bring healing to them and give them peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the many parish projects, Vacation Bible School, Rock Your Faith, Blood Drive, Parish Hospitality, and a candidate to fill our music ministry needs, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Gary and Rita Egler, for whom this Mass is offered, and those who have recently died, Glenn Colin, Jim Merkley, Jeanette John, Joan Schrering, Robert Giesler, Florence Hostetter, and all fathers, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, in your love and in your mercy, you hear the needs of your people. We ask you to grant our petitions according to your will through Christ our Lord.
Please join in singing with our offertory hymn, number 409, Drawn to You, number 409.
Drawn to you, Lord, we are drawn to you, to the beauty of your presence in this place. Here for you, God, we are here for you, as the gifts we bring become a feast of grace. We are drawn to you. Drawn by the love that you have poured on us, we bring these gifts, works of our hands. You gather all we offer to yourself, receive our prayer. Drawn to you, Lord, we are drawn to you, to the beauty of your presence in this place. Here for you, God, we are here for you, as the gifts we bring become a feast of grace. We are drawn to you. Drawn by the faith that you accept our gifts and sanctify what we have shared to make us holy by this bread and wine, receive our prayer. Drawn to you, Lord, we are drawn to you, to the beauty of your presence in this place. Here for you, God, you are here for you, as the gifts we bring become a feast of grace. We are drawn to you. Drawn by the table you have laid for us, the welcome feast your heart prepares. The words now spoken you will make us one, receive our prayer. Drawn to you, Lord, we are drawn to you, to the beauty of your presence in this place. Here for you, God, we are here for you, as the gifts we bring become a feast of grace. We are drawn to you. We are drawn to you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. O God, who in the offerings presented here, provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth, he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. By ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. So with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. And therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your Pilgrim Church on earth with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow in the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command,
informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
join in singing number 764, Goodness of the Lord, number 764.
Thank you.
Let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord. I ask you to be seated briefly. We would like to give a blessing to our fathers and grandfathers. So if there's some grandfathers, you may just stand in your place. I think there are too many of you for all to come forward. Loving God, we give you thanks for the many gifts you have given us, the gift of life, the gift of those who love us, and especially today, we thank you for the gift of fathers. We ask your blessing upon our fathers who gave us rules to live by, standards to uphold, joys to cherish, faith to live by, hopes worth dreaming, and who have blessed our lives with their unselfish and unconditional love. We ask your blessing upon the fathers standing here before us. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Give them the strength to live the faithful and loving lives you call them to live. Protect and guide them. Keep them in your care and grant that their children may honor them with love and respect. We ask this in the name of Jesus our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may all stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is number 506, Faith of Our Fathers, number 506.